What's it all about?
Gaudi.
Is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when you start it out?
Gaudi. Anthony Gaudi was born in 1852 in Tarragona, Spain.
A first house, a young architect, a different Gaudi. We welcome you to Casa Vicens, Anthony Gaudi's first house.
He studied at the Barcelona School of Architecture, where his principal director declared, "We have given this degree to a madman or a genius. Only time will tell." We enjoyed some drinking chocolate before starting our tour. Casa Vicens was a project for the tile producer Manuel Vicens, so Gaudi had a ready supply of construction materials. Our architect was also economical, using one tile pattern, copying the marigolds found in the garden, that could be turned in four directions and used all over the house. It also served as an advertisement for its owner's ventures, the Barcelona construction sector, and the craftsmanship of the area's artisans. Up on the roof, we see the first of his amazing chimneys. He generates a kaleidoscope of colour with the checkerboard patterned flowery tiles, which are a characteristic typical of Moorish or Muslim design.
On to the palace of Eusebi Güell, a textile mogul who had known Gaudi for 8 years before he asked him to design his mansion in central Barcelona. The palace basement was used by the horses and carriages with direct access via a specially designed ramp made entirely of brick, with the exception of the flooring, which was wooden. This helped to lessen the noise made by the animals' hooves. The stained glass windows are in the colours of the Catalan flag. On Sunday, we attended Mass in Barcelona Cathedral. As we came out, we were surprised and delighted to see the square full of local people dancing together in traditional Catalan style. There was a full band playing, and we were fascinated by the piccolo player, who had a tiny drum attached to his left elbow, which he tapped in rhythm. The young dancers were terribly serious and full of concentration.
Oh.
Park's magnificent staircase. Empty in this picture, but very crowded when we visited. The dragon has become the park's and the city of Barcelona's most celebrated sculpture. And we all want to have our photo taken beside it. Marketplace has been inspired by the temples of ancient Greece. What a park!
At the beginning of the 20th century, wealthy Spanish businessmen wanted to show off their power by commissioning large, impressive houses in the main street of Barcelona. Josep Batlló commissioned Gaudi, who designed a large block of flats. The central patio well was tiled in 5 shades of blue. This allowed light into the apartments. On the roof, more cover with amazing chimneys.
We now conclude with the pinnacle of Gaudi's work, the Holy Family Church, or Sagrada Familia. Today, it is considered to be a masterpiece of world art. The tallest church in Europe with 18 towers. When finished, its total capacity is 14,000 people. Gaudi considered the temple as a stone Bible that explains the history and mysteries of Christianity. Although he found inspiration in many styles of building and decoration, including Gothic, Moorish, and Art Nouveau, all of these elements were transmuted through his imagination into structures of breathtaking originality. His eccentricity, playfulness, and fantasy are once again being valued and enjoyed. He was commissioned in 1883, aged 31, and devoted 43 years of his life to it. From 1914, aged 63, he rejected any other commission and dedicated all of his time and energy to the construction of the Sagrada Familia. He went to live in the workroom of the cathedral in 1925, but he was going to visit his local church in 1926 and was knocked down by a tram. He died in hospital a few days later and was buried in the crypt of his temple. The Sagrada Familia is expected and hoped to be completed in 2026, 100 years after its conception. The work of this genius will last forever.
What's it all about?
Gaudi. 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 Gaudi.